going on, everyone? Got a brand new movie review for you guys today, and today I'm discussing Netflix's new original film, Apostle. Apostle is directed by Gareth Evans, the man who directed Raid 1 and Raid 2, both action films, which are probably some of the best action films ever made. If you've never watched them, go check them out. But Gareth Evans, this is his long-awaited film for me, especially. I've been dying to see this film. I heard it has horror elements to it. It's from the guy who made The Raid, and it has Dan Stevens. Plus, it's about crazy cult that Dan Stevens has to go after to save his sister. And man, oh man, when I heard that, I was all on board for this movie. And let me tell you, for me at least, it did not disappoint. This film has a 2-hour and 10-minute runtime, and that runtime flew by, and I could have at least used a little bit more time within this cult establishment. I absolutely really love this film for a lot of different reasons. Now, I'll go as far as say it's not a perfect movie, and there are some issues that I do have with it, minor nitpicks to it at least. We'll say, though, this is a very nice little horror film that has a lot of thrilling moments to it. It's not your typical horror film where it's psychological or it has a ton of jump scares. No, it's one of those horror films it's a horror film on its surface, but in the layers of it, it's thrilling, it's a period piece, plus it has some nice action to it as well. Well, I mean, per se, it's not like the most over-the-top action film like The Raids are, but this is very much a subtle type of movie that gets you on the edge of your seat as you're discovering more about this cult. Because on the surface, when he got to the island at first, I was like, oh my god, I was like, this cult's actually pretty nice. But then once you start learning more about it, you're like, no, there's some messed up things going around here. Actually, on the surface, when you meet Michael Sheen's character, who plays the main preacher slash prophet, the leader of this cult in a settlement, who discovered this island, who discovered this cult with his two friends, and he is just superb in here. Probably gives the best performance out of everyone in here, but he gives one of those subtle performances where you care for his character, but you're understanding what he's doing. He cares so much about his cult and what he believes in, and you understand that. And as a villain character, you're getting his perspective, which is good because in his eyes, he is the hero. When you see that kind of development within villains themselves. If we're talking about anyone else in here, Dan Stevens is always great. He's fantastic in here. But what I will say about his character is it's not his fault particularly, but it's how the script is written. Obviously, he's going to this island to save his sister. I'm going to be honest, though, I didn't care about his sister. I felt like there could have been a little bit of a flashback or some more stuff in the beginning to make me care about the relationship. Maybe a little bit of tinkering of the script would have made me really do that, but I didn't care what his journey was. I was just more interested with the cult and what he was discovering within this island. Dan Stevens' character, you do care about because it's Dan Stevens in a sense, but I just never got to that layer where I was really caring about the mission. But thank God the film is so, like, heavy with mythology and exploration that I was on board with still with this journey, especially with some of the subtle characters that you do meet in here and you start to understand. There's one little subplot in the movie that is about two younger kids within this cult, which I did like, but I also didn't love. I felt like it wasn't needed, and by the over end of the plot, I was just sitting there, I was like, why was this in the movie? You could have given me a little bit more about Dan Stevens. It does explore a little bit of the mythology of the cult, though, and it does get into more layers of that. I do think that you could have moved in and switched it around a bit, because in reality, I cared more about those characters than I ever did about Dan Stevens' relationship with his sister. It picks out of the way, seriously. This film is thrilling, top to bottom. When the film started, it just gets you into it, and it's at a fast pace. It's getting you here, it's getting you to the island, and making you move forward. I'm going to stay very vague within what's on the island and what you learn about the cult, but there are some awesome little things in here. It's supernatural in a sense, but maybe it's not, and you're kind of just getting there going, what is going on here? Some really horrifying moments. There's this one claustrophobic moment where Dan Stevens is kind of crawling through a little cave that has water and everything in it, and he's barely able to breathe or really see anything, but there's some horrific stuff that happens down there that I was like, oh my god, this is awesome. And it doesn't come off cheesy. None of the film ever comes off cheesy. And there's some other moments in here where, again, the Raid director Gareth Evans is really known for the way that he swings the camera around during action sequences. There's a couple small action sequences in here where you do really feel that. One with a guy fighting another preacher inside a house, and the way that he's moving the camera around as they're fighting with just bare bones, knives, and fists, it's great. Then there's some other moments with spears, and when Dan Stevens kind of dodge them or move around them and move about, it's so great. It's so good how he moved the camera angles, and that's Gareth Evans' staples, because he knows how to do that. Some directors obviously have their own ways of moving it around with CGI, but I don't know how he does it, how he moves the camera so fast, but however he does it, it works for the film, and it works for the style, and it's great to see that Evans' style really does fit within a horror film. It's great to see him branch off into this, because yeah, like I said, it does have a little bit of action here, but the best way to kind of describe this film is if you took a little bit of The Witch, shook it up and made it not as much indie film, threw it into a pile, and then mixed in the Raid in there, stirred it up, then poured a little bit of The Village to Resident Evil 7, Outlast 2, meshed it together, started it around, and you get Apostle. Absolutely love The Apostle. I think this is definitely a film that you guys should check out. It's a very different, unique type of horror thriller film. Definitely one of the best crazy cult films that you'll see in the horror genre. So with all that said, I'm going to give Apostle an A-. Really impressed me with this one. I had high expectations and they definitely lived up to it. Didn't exceed it because some of the other minor elements, and I would have really liked to care about those characters a little bit more, but I cannot recommend this film enough. Please go check it out and please comment down below and tell me what your guys' thoughts were on Apostle. Have you heard of this film? Have you not? Have you seen The Raid 1 and 2? Let's talk about it down below in the comments. If you're new here, hit that like and subscribe button. Then go check out Sandwich on Films also down below, because right down there you guys can get into advanced movie screens. You can also check out some giveaways, plus check out some movie news and even some movie reviews. Guys, of course, until next time, look out for more reviews soon. And stay classy.